Hello students, welcome to UGC EPG Pathshala on Quantitative Methods in Geography. I am Professor Aslam Mahmood, formerly from Jawaharlal Nehru University. Today we are going to discuss matrices, representation of equations in matrix form and their solutions. Matrix algebra is an important branch of mathematics dealing with the handling of the large body of data for its tabulation, representation and statistical analysis. It helps us in representing large body of equations and their mathematical analysis in a fast and concise way. In this age of quantitative revolution, world is flooded with huge amount of data in every walk of the life, and computers play an important role in analyzing the data in a much faster way. Most of the computer software for multivariate analysis therefore require data input in matrix forms only. The definition of a matrix is that matrix is an arrangement of numbers in a rectangular form of rows and columns like the one given below. A matrix could have several rows and columns. In the above case, the matrix has three columns and three rows. A matrix of three rows and two columns would look like the given here. Similarly, a matrix with two rows and three columns would also look like as given here. A matrix which has only one column is known as a column vector, like the one here. And similarly, a matrix with only one row is known as a row vector, like the given here. Number of rows and columns of a matrix are known as its dimensions and are written in the form like M into N, which means m rows and n columns. If the dimension of a matrix are 3 into 3, it means 3 rows and 3 columns. Similarly, the dimension of a matrix with 4 rows and 7 columns will be written as 4 by 7. A matrix which has equal number of rows and columns is known as a square matrix, like a 2 by 2, 3 by 3, 4 by 4, 6 by 6, etc. If number of columns and rows of the matrix are not equal, it is known as rectangular matrix. However, a matrix with one column or one row only is known as a vector. Dimension of a 4-value column vector will be 4 into 1, as it will have 4 rows and only 1 column. And a 5-value row vector will be 1 into 5, as it will have 1 row only but 5 columns. Each element of a matrix is known as an element and is denoted by Aij, where I and j are known as subscripts and represent the number of rows and columns respectively. The element A 2 by 3 means the element corresponding to second row and third column. The element of a square matrix corresponding to same row and same column like A 1 1, A 2 2, A 3 3, etc. are known as principal diagonal elements. There are certain types of matrices which have their equivalence in arithmetic also. For example, equivalence of a 0 in arithmetic is null matrix in matrix algebra. Null matrix. A null matrix is a square matrix whose all cell values are 0. Like a 3 by 3 null matrix would be as given here. Identity are a unit matrix. Similarly, equivalence of a unity or 1 in matrix is an identity matrix, which is a square matrix whose all the diagonal elements are 1 and half diagonal elements are 0. A 2 by 2 identity matrix would be like the given here, and a 3 by 3 identity matrix would be like given here. An identity matrix is denoted by capital I. Diagonal matrix, a matrix whose all off diagonal elements are all 0, but diagonal elements are other than 0, is known as a diagonal matrix. For example, the matrix given here is a diagonal matrix. Symmetric matrix, a square matrix whose element Aij is equal to element Aji is known as symmetric matrix. The matrix given here is a symmetric matrix, as among all of its off diagonal elements Aij is equal to Aji. One can verify that element A2 by 3 is equal to A3 by 2 is equal to 1. Element A1 by 3 is equal to A3 by 1, which is equal to 3. And element A2 1 by 2 is equal to element A2 by 1, which is equal to 7. Likewise, the matrix given here is a 2 by 2 symmetric matrix. Similarly, we can have a matrix which is a square matrix of any other dimension also, transpose of a matrix. If the rows and columns of a matrix A are interchanged, the new matrix is known as transpose of A and is represented by a dash on it. For example, if we have A is equal to as given here, we know that in transpose the dimensions also change. Number of rows become number of columns and number of columns become number of rows. In the present case, A is a 3 by 2 matrix, but A transpose is a 2 by 3 matrix. A row vector after transpose will become a column vector. A symmetry matrix, however, remains unchanged after transpose. Thus, another definition of a square symmetric matrix is that if A transpose is equal to A, the matrix is said to be symmetrical. A scalar matrix, any square matrix whose all the diagonal elements are equal and all the off diagonal elements are 0 is known as diagonal matrix. For example, a matrix given here are scalar matrices of the order of 2 by 2 and 3 by 3. Like simple algebra, all the four arithmetic operations are also possible in matrix also. In matrix algebra, these operations of different sets of numbers are performed simultaneously. Matrix addition and subtraction. Two matrices of identical dimensions can be added or subtracted by adding or subtracting their values of the corresponding element. It is to be noted that if the dimensions of any two matrices are not equal, they cannot be added or subtracted. Example, given here, one can verify that the values of the elements of the last matrix giving the sum of the values of the corresponding elements of the given matrices. For example, 3 plus 1 is equal to 4 is the sum of the values of the first row and first column of two matrices. Similarly, if we have to subtract the two matrices given here, the resultant matrix will have the difference of the corresponding values of the two matrices as shown above. Multiplication. Multiplication of two matrices also involves multiplication of their elements, but in a different way. It takes the elements of the first row of the first matrix and multiply the corresponding elements of the first column of the second matrix to get A11 of the product matrix, that is the first row and first column element of the product matrix. Thus, number of columns of the first matrix, that is number of elements in it, should be equal to the number of rows, that is the number of elements in the column of the second matrix should be equal. Similarly, we repeat the process by taking the second column of the second matrix, we get the values of A12 of the product matrix. By changing the columns of the second matrix, retaining the first column of the first matrix, we get the different values of the first row of the product matrix. We repeat the process by taking the second row of the first matrix and get the different values of the second row of the product matrix. At the end, we get the values of the product matrix with rows equal to the number of rows of the first matrix and columns equal to the number of columns of the second matrix. So, if the dimensions of the two matrices are 3 by 4 and 4 by 5, the dimension of the product matrix will be 3 by 5. Note that number of columns of the first matrix is 4 and number column of the second matrix is also 4. The two matrices can be multiplied and the dimensions of the product matrix will be 3 by 5, that is the number of rows of the first matrix 3 and the number of columns of the second matrix 5. Example, we will take a simple example of multiplication of two matrices A and B as given below. You can see that the product of A and B is just as mentioned above. We note that the two matrices can be multiplied as they have required dimensions, but the two products are not the same, that is A into B is not equal to B into A. Also note that when an identity or unit matrix is multiplied to any matrix confirming the dimension, the product is the matrix itself, that is identity matrix multiplied by matrix A is equal to A only, where another matrix A is multiplied by another identity matrix again gives you A. Thus, the commutative law will hold good only if one of the factor matrix is identity matrix. That is, I into A is equal to A into I. First multiplier is known as prefactor and the second is known as the postfactor. Example, if the dimension of the two matrices are 2 by 3 and 3 is equal to 3 into 3 like the matrix given here, they can be multiplied as shown below. The dimensions of the product of A into B will be 2 into 3 and 3 into 3 is equal to 2 into 3. We note that B is into A is not possible as the dimensions of the prefactor B in this case are such that it cannot be multiplied with the postfactor A. Scalar multiplication. If a matrix is to be multiplied by a constant instead of a matrix or a vector, all the elements of the matrix will get multiplied by that constant or scalar. So, if we have a matrix A as given here and a scalar lambda is equal to 5, then 5 multiplied by A will be A, all the elements of A are multiplied by lambda. Minor and cofactor of a square matrix. In any square matrix, if we delete ith row and jth column, the determinant of the remaining matrix is known as the minor of the element A, I, J. Every element will have a minor, and if these minors are attached with a sign given in the sequence as here, these are known as corresponding cofactors of every Aij and is denoted by capital Aij. Determinant of a square matrix. Every square matrix has a value which is known as its determinant and is denoted by two vertical lines on either side of it. The determinant of a square matrix A will be denoted by A with two modulus sign. Determinant of a 2 by 2 square matrix is worked out by taking the difference of the product of diagonal terms and the product of the remaining half diagonal terms. For a 3 by 3 matrix as given here, the determinant will be A11 multiplied by the cofactor of A11 plus A12 multiplied by the cofactor of A12 plus A13 multiplied by cofactor of A13. Thus, in a 3 by 3 matrix, A is as given here, the determinant will be as shown here. A square matrix is known as singular matrix if its determinant is found to be 0. Properties of determinant. In any square matrix, following are the properties of the determinants. Interchanging of rows and columns will not change the value of the determinant. In any row or column, if all the values are 0, the value of the determinant will be 0. Interchanging any two rows or columns will reverse the sign of the value of the determinant. If any two rows or columns of a matrix are same, the value of the determinant will be 0. If the value of any row or column are multiplied by a constant, the value of the determinant will also be multiplied by that constant. If to any row or column, any other row or column is added after multiplying by a constant, the value of the determinant will not change. Adjoint of a square matrix. Transpose of a matrix formed by the cofactors of its each element is known as its adjoint. For example, if we have a matrix A is as given here, for the adjoint of a square matrix A, the cofactor matrix is as given here, and its transpose is adjoint of A. Thus, adjoint of A will be as shown here. Inverse of a matrix. Inverse of a matrix is equivalent to division in arithmetic, but in a very indirect way. In arithmetic, if a number A is divided by another number B and we get A into B equal to 1, then B is said to be the inverse of A, and A inverse is B. A inverse is denoted by A inverse as given here. Example, given A is equal to as here, B is equal to as given here, we find that A into B is an identity matrix and A is said to be the inverse of B. Thus, if we have to divide any matrix by another matrix, say A, we can achieve it by multiplying the matrix by the inverse of A. Computation of the inverse of a symmetric matrix. The inverse of a non-singular symmetric matrix is worked out by using the relationship A inverse is equal to 1 upon determinant of A multiplied by adjoint of A, provided determinant A is not zero. That is, A is non-singular matrix. Example, find the inverse of matrix A, which is given as the column values are 2, 4, and the second column is 3 minus 1. We know we can work out the determinant of A as minus 1 multiplied by 2 minus 4 into 3 is equal to minus 14. That is the multiplication of the diagonal term 2 and minus 1 minus the multiplication of another diagonal term 4 and 3. The adjoint of A is worked out by working out the determinant of each element and then taking transpose of it. The determinant of the first element is minus 1, the second element is minus 4, the third, second element of the first row is minus 3, the second element of second row is 2. So it is making a 2 by 2 matrix, minus 1, minus 3, minus 4, 2, and transpose of it will be the adjoint A, which will be the column of the first column would be minus 1, minus 4, second column would be minus 3 and 2. So the inverse of A would be obtained by dividing the elements of the adjoint of A by the determinant of A, which is minus 14. So if I divide all the elements of the adjoint of A and divide them by 14, we get 1 by 14, 4 by 14, 3 by 14, and minus 2 by 14. We can verify that multiplication of this inverse with the original matrix of which it is the inverse A will give you the identity matrix, that is a matrix 2 by 2 matrix whose elements, whose diagonal elements are 1, 1 and the off diagonal elements are 0, 0. Example, find the inverse of A of a 3 by 3 matrix. The column wise the matrix is 1, 2, minus 4, the second column is 2, 5, minus 4, the third column is 3, 7, minus 4. The determinant of this matrix is worked out as given here and is found to be 1. The inverse of this will require the adjoint of A divided by all the elements of A by the determinant of A. We can find out the adjoint of A as given above. The adjoint works out to be as given here, column wise 3, minus 4, 2, minus 2, 1, 0, minus 1, minus 1, and 1. If I divide it by 1, it remains the same, and this will become the inverse of the given 3 by 3 matrix. The dimension of the inverse will also be 3 by 3. We can verify that multiplication of A with its inverse is equal to identity matrix of the order of 3 by 3. Note that as the dimensions of matrix increase, the computation of inverse becomes more and more difficult, and we have to take the help of computers and statistical packages for its calculation. Now we come to simultaneous equations and their solutions through matrix algebra. Biggest advantage of matrix method is that it can simultaneously handle a large body of information. Taking advantage of this property, we can represent and solve a large number of equations in a concise and efficient manner. For example, if we have a set of three simultaneous linear equations in three variables x1, x2, and 3 as given below, a11 x1 plus a12 x2 plus a13 x3 is equal to c1. Similarly, the second equation, and we have a third equation. This system of three simultaneous linear equations can also be written in matrix form as shown here. A is a 3x3 coefficient matrix, X is a column vector which is equal to C, another column vector equal to the constant. These equations can further be written in a concise form as Ax is equal to C, where A is a 3x3 square matrix and X and C are column vectors, matrix of order 3x1. Solution of these equations is possible by pre-multiplying both the sides by inverse of A, which will give us X equal to A inverse C. Note that A inverse multiplied by A is equal to I, which is the identity matrix. Multiplication of I with X will not change X. The above equation will hold good for any number of variables with the condition that number of independent equations should be equal to the number of variables to give us a non-singular symmetric matrix of A. In case the number of equations are not independent, matrix A will not become singular and inverse of matrix A will not exist. Now, here we see that with the help of matrix algebra, we can solve the simultaneous equations in one go. And the advantage will be more when there will be large number of variables other than x1, x2 and x3. Then manually it will become very difficult to solve those equations with the help of traditional methods. If we use matrix methods, we can use the above equations and get a solution, and if we use the computers, even large number of variables can be, the equations with large number of variables can be solved with not much time. If you take say the example given above, we can be handled with the help of matrix algebra, and if we denote the above example in matrix form, the matrix A will be as given here, X will be as given here, a column vector, C will also be a column vector. Inverse of A is found to be as given here. Using A inverse, we get A inverse C. Thus, the solution of the above equation is equal to x1 is equal to 2, x1 is equal to 1, x2 is equal to 2 and x3 is equal to 3. Now, the method can be used for large number of variables also. So, we see that matrix methods helps us in handling large amount of information in a very systematic, concise and very precise manner in a shortest amount of time. So, I hope you enjoyed the simple exposition to matrix algebra, and when these notations are used to explain multivariate analysis in books on statistics, you will find it much easier to understand and follow. I hope you enjoyed and you will be able to make use of matrix algebra in your research also. Thank you very much.